The engine is here. It all gets serious today. All packaged up still. 420 cc, 16 horsepower. Electric start, brand new. Everything's all shiny. It's Carroll Stream, which is more of a legit Honda copy brand. Overhead valve, carbureted of course. Huge muffler and air intake, choke, fuel select, the throttle, which will need to be loosened up because it comes tightened down. Roughly the same size block as this thing, but yet it puts out twice as much power as the old floppy cock Kawasaki. Sweet. This is how it'll basically sit inside the golf cart. It's only just sitting on the plate right now, so it's not buttoned down or anything, but of course not gonna need this exhaust because I have my redneck exhaust. This is all going to be removed, this electric start box here, because I'm going to wire it up to the dashboard, of course, so then I can move the engine further back. But as you can see, it's designed, so this kind of, see how this kind of fits perfectly? Tongue and groove, no pun intended. Going to chop chop right here, get some flex pipe to go over to the redneck muffler. It's got the keyway 1-inch shaft. Put some oil in it, take off that box, put a couple bolts in it, some gas, and then we'll bench test it. All right, so as I disassemble it, let me tell you about the 1-year manufacturer's warranty. Well, there's a 1-year manufacturer's warranty. Oh, 90-day parts warranty. So, that's good. I'd use a crescent wrench for that one. But of course, always save your original parts. Keep track of your parts, as Polly would say. Whoa. That's on there pretty good. And don't strip your bolts and don't smash your knuckles, which I'll probably do here. Ooh, there we go. Connect electrical connections. Oh, that's where those extra nuts and bolts go for this thing here. This is the alternator. It's got a 3-amp alternator system in it, by the way. For you motorhead guys who order engines, you'll know what smell I'm talking about. Let's connect the harness. There's your electric start box. Of course, this is valuable, so I'm gonna save it. All right, the electric start switch has been removed. I did have to temporarily relocate the starter cell. Now, as you can see, everything, it's very precisely how this thing fits. Stuck a couple of bolts in it just to kind of hold it down. I'm gonna add some oil and some gas, and we're gonna do a bench test. Weight. Got oil. Now adding some gas. Where's that basket? It's from the shed. Alright, so I actually forgot that electric start box is my only source of a kill switch, so Gotta leave that on. Camera's running out of battery, so put that on. Gas is on. It's just gonna take a few pumps to get this thing going.
Yes, it's running.